He went from knowing next to nothing about rockets to becoming the CEO of the world's largest private space exploration company. With SpaceX now valued at over $100 billion, he has built a net worth of $185 billion, making him the wealthiest man on the planet. Former engineer at SpaceX Robert Zubrin describes just how quickly Musk was able to learn and absorb information in order to make the transition from rocket science rookie to becoming an industry-leading expert in just 6 years. He wrote, "He did not know anything about rockets. Nothing. That was in 2001. By 2007, he knew everything about rockets. He really knew everything, in detail." What Elon Musk was trying to do, essentially create a space company to compete with NASA, the biggest space organization in the world. There was a whole graveyard of dead bodies that Musk had to step over that tried to do this before him. Billionaire businessman Andrew Beal spent $100 million trying to do exactly what Musk was aiming to do, and he went bankrupt. So at the time, space exploration was considered a government domain that nobody really dared to step into. But Elon's approach was different. He defined a goal, and he put a lot of effort into understanding what that goal was and why it was a goal worthy of spending the vast majority of his life pursuing. His goal back in 2001, a year before SpaceX was formed, was to make mankind a multiplanetary species, and the first problem he had to solve was the transportation problem. And to this day, that goal has not changed. Once he had his goal, his next step was to learn as much about the subject area as possible. And in this video, we're going to go through four main ways he was able to learn and process vast amounts of information in such short periods of time. And he used learning methods that all of us, every single one of us, both me and you, can implement into our lives to learn faster and become an expert in any field. And before I go on, a lot of people watching are probably thinking, Elon Musk is more of a businessman, right? He's more of a businessman than an engineer. He doesn't really get that involved in the building and engineering of the rockets, right? Well, not exactly.
You probably don't remember this. A very long time ago, many, many years, you took me on a tour of SpaceX. And the most impressive thing was that you knew every detail of the rocket and every piece of engineering that went into it.
My time is almost entirely with the engineering team working on improving the Falcon 9 and the Dragon spacecraft and developing the Mars colonial architecture.
And there's an interesting post on Quora from Tim Warstall, who is a journalist, and at the time he was a global expert in a very rare type of metal. It was an aluminium scandium, which the Russians had developed to compete with NASA's aluminium lithium. And a number of years back, he received an email from a guy called Elon Musk. He was very vaguely aware of who he was, but back then he was nowhere near as well known as he is now. And he gets an email asking whether the aluminium scandium will actually make his rockets lighter, and Tim replied back that it wouldn't make them lighter, but it'd make them easier to weld. And that was pretty much the end of the exchange. So when people ask whether Musk is involved in the engineering side of SpaceX, at least to me, it's pretty obvious that he is. He managed to track down a one-man company that knew the straight answer to the question he needed answering. So the first and arguably the most efficient way that Elon Musk became an expert in rocket science was that he surrounded himself with experts. In 2001, he would cold call industry leaders in the aerospace field, just hoping that they would pick up the phone. Jim Cantrell was an experienced aerospace engineer and an expert in Russian rockets, having joined the French Space Agency back in 1990 and going on to work at the joint French-Soviet Mars program. And Musk ended up cold calling Cantrell back in 2001, just before SpaceX was launched. And Cantrell explained, "I had the top down on my car, so all I could make out was that some guy named Elon Musk was saying that he was an internet billionaire and needed to talk to me." I'm pretty sure he used that phrase, internet billionaire. He also wrote in a Quora post answering someone's question of how did Elon Musk actually learn enough about rockets to create and run SpaceX? And he replied, "He literally sucks the knowledge and experience out of people that he is around. We also hired as many of my colleagues in the rocket and spacecraft business that were willing to consult with him." Learning from people much better at that particular area is such an incredibly effective way of learning, far more efficient than reading books or watching YouTube videos or listening to podcasts, because when you're talking one-on-one to someone, you can receive direct feedback in real time. You can ask specific, focused questions. And Elon's mother, May Musk, noticed this specific trait in him from a young age, saying in an interview, "Even at an early age, he would always migrate to the most successful person in the room, and he would just stand there and listen, and then ask very pointed questions. They were always highly intelligent and highly directed." And it made sense. When I was studying economics at university, I noticed something interesting. We would be taught in a matter of a couple of hours things that the best economists in the world, Nobel Prize winning economists, took decades to develop. And leading the way is easy, but being the first one is far more difficult. Musk employed the people that had already cut the path through the jungle, and he constantly asked them questions to pick their brain and learn from them as much as he could. And he used their expertise in the field of aerospace engineering to show him the ropes. One former SpaceX employee said that Elon Musk would quiz you until he knew 90% of what you knew. He even moved from Silicon Valley to Los Angeles because he realized that the highest concentration of rocket scientists, rocket engineers, and experts in that field were mostly congregated in and around the LA area. And Musk has spoken about this in a number of interviews. He essentially had two options. The first option was to form SpaceX in Silicon Valley and try to encourage as many space and rocket engineers who lived in and around Southern California and LA to move up north to Silicon Valley. And the second option was to form the company in LA, which would benefit his employees too, because housing in Silicon Valley is notoriously expensive. So in his own words, Silicon Valley wasn't really a viable option for him and SpaceX. The second way Musk taught himself rocket science links in with what he calls his single best piece of advice. In an interview back in 2012, he said, "I think it's very important to have a feedback loop where you're constantly thinking about what you've done and how you could be doing it better. I think that's the single best piece of advice. Constantly think about how you could be doing things better and questioning yourself." The feedback loop is unquestionably part of every successful person's growing process. Being open to receiving feedback is one of Musk's biggest strengths. As Steve Jobs once said, "It doesn't make sense to hire smart people and tell them what to do. We hire smart people so that they can tell us what to do." And Musk does exactly that. He hires smart people that are constantly giving feedback on every part of his business. His aim to improve a particular product or business process is to intentionally try not to be the smartest person in the room. He hires people with far more experience than himself and solicits consistent feedback to improve himself and his businesses, so he's constantly learning and growing. The third way Elon Musk was able to turn himself into an aerospace expert in just a few years was that he read books. He read a lot of books, and he often credits much of his success to this. Throughout his childhood, books have played a crucial role in fueling his ambition. At the age of 9, he would read the entire Encyclopedia Britannica and would pore through science fiction books for 10 hours or more a day. And Elon's uncle, Scott Haldeman, said he never went anywhere without a book in his hand. He was always reading, and he was often advanced books. That was one of the earliest things you started seeing. It was this intense reading, and they were books about the future and about success. According to his brother, Musk would read through 2 books a day. And if you, like the average person, read 1 book a month, that means Musk would read 60 times as many books as you. And they were from a whole range of disciplines, from Soviet rocket manuals, encyclopedias, science fiction, and biographies.
Biographies, I think, are really, you know, really interesting read.
What do you learn from them?
Well, I think you learn a lot, depending upon, you know, whose life you're reading about. There are lots of lessons in there. I read Isaacson's biography of Jobs, which I thought was quite interesting. And I actually really liked his biography of Benjamin Franklin, who I would say is certainly one of my heroes. He seemed like a really great guy.
And I actually made a video the other week on the 3 favorite books that have transformed my life. And spoiler alert, the first book in the video is Elon Musk's biography, so you can click on the pop-out banner above to watch that. Musk firmly believes that most people can learn faster and learn more efficiently, more than they actually realize. He wrote in a Reddit comment, "I think most people can learn a lot more than they think they can. They sell themselves short without trying, and reading biographies can help combat that by showing you that if you play your cards right, extraordinary things can happen." In a Reddit thread in 2015, Elon Musk explained how he learns new information by viewing knowledge as a tree. By using this learning method, he was able to process and retain so much information in the field of aerospace engineering in such a short space of time. Musk wrote, "It is important to view knowledge as sort of a semantic tree. Make sure you understand the fundamental principles, i.e. the trunk and big branches, before you get into the leaves, details, or there is nothing for them to hang on to." And this approach makes sense. Imagine a child trying to read an encyclopedia when he doesn't even know how to read in the first place. It makes more sense for him to start learning with single words and then move on to children's books and slowly progress to more complex books. The basics of reading need to be understood before he can move on to the next level. And Musk's entire career is based on this principle. First, he learned the fundamentals of economics and physics at the University of Pennsylvania, where he received a dual bachelor's degree in economics and physics. Then he deconstructed these ideas and reconstructed them in new ways. So for example, PayPal reshaped traditional banking by allowing for seamless online payments, and Tesla shook up the car industry by releasing mass market electric vehicles, forcing every other major manufacturer to follow suit. And SpaceX also shook up the once almost entirely government-owned industry by being the first private spaceflight company to send a crewed spacecraft to space. Something as basic as viewing knowledge as a tree and understanding the fundamental principles before you get into the details can be an incredibly powerful approach to business, but also to your studying, your work, your health, your fitness, your relationships, pretty much every single area in your life. And if you are on a journey of growing and learning to develop yourself, last week I made a video on the three books that transformed my life, and a few books mentioned over there: Elon Musk, Steve Jobs, Arnold Schwarzenegger's biographies, The Richest Man in Babylon, How to Win Friends and Influence People, Rich Dad Poor Dad, just to name a few. And if you like this video, you're gonna love that one, so I'll see you over there.